said the traveler, knocking on the moonlit door, and his horse in the silence champed the grasses of the forest's ferny floor. And a bird flew up out of the turret above the traveler's head, and he smote on the door again a second time. Is there anybody there, he said. But no one descended to the traveler, no head from the leaf-fringed sill. Leaned over and looked into his gray eyes, where he stood perplexed and still. Only a host of phantom whistles dwelt in the lone house then, stood listening in the quiet of the moonlight to that voice from the world of men. Stood thronging the faint moonbeams on the dark stair that goes down to the empty hall, hearkening in an air stirred and shaken by the lonely traveler's call. And he felt in his heart their strangeness, their stillness answering his cry, while his horse moved, cropping the dark turf neath the starred leafy sky. Before he suddenly smote, every word he spake fell echoing through the shadowiness of the still house when the one man left away. Aye, they heard his foot upon the stirrup, the sound of iron on stone, and how the silence surged softly backward when the